Okay, so if you're using Google Sheets and you have a list of data, like I put into column B here, and we're calling this a grocery list, and we want to see if anything is missing from this list in another list. So a good way to do that is to use conditional formatting in a way that highlights the values in the grocery list that are missing from the cart. Yeah, first we're going to work on the formula that we're going to use in conditional formatting. So we'll put it into this column, we'll talk about what it's doing, and then we'll paste it into conditional formatting. What we want to do is we want to count the value if, what we want to count is we want to look at the values in column D. So we'll just select these. And one important thing to remember is you need to fix the row numbers that they don't move down when you evaluate the subsequent rows. So we're going to look at D2, but we'll put a dollar sign before the 2 through D11. So now that we fix those rows, when we look at B3 to see if it's a repeat, it'll still just be looking at this list without shifting down. All right, so at the end of that range, we'll use a comma to say we're going to give it the criteria now. And what we're looking for is leaks. That's the value in B2, right? So we want to look to see if this value is in the cart. Now we'll close this off, and that function's done. It's pretty simple. Let's drag this down so that we're checking every value in our grocery list. And you get lots of ones, you get a few zeros, and you get some twos. We're going to write our conditional formatting to highlight it if this is equal to zero. And that's because if you look at these values, so cheese, it's not in the list. So it looked for it in column D, couldn't find it, so it returned zero. Same thing with cherries and coffee. So let's grab this formula. We're going to put it on our clipboard. Just copied it. We'll highlight the list. We'll go to format and conditional formatting. So the range is already selected because we just did that with our mouse. We're going to format the cells if, so we'll drop this down and use a custom formula. And then it's waiting for the formula. Left click in the box that says value. Let's paste that formula we just worked on. And it's not working quite yet. It's actually working backwards, but conditional formatting needs to have a true false value. So it'll highlight if the result is true. It won't do anything if it's false. So to make this true, we'll say equals zero. We'll click done and let's come over here and every value. So remember, this is a very similar function to what's happening in E. Every value where it's zero, it's going to highlight. Let's just get rid of these and you're done. So that's a really easy way to identify values that are in one column but missing from another. And next, let's talk about a similar process, but we're actually going to highlight duplicates in one list.